All right, everyone, I'm back. You know the voice. You know who I am. I'm all here. My name's Major. I'm joined tonight by the Eye in the Sky himself, 420, who's also going to be hanging out. Corky finished her bottle of wine. She is hanging out in general chat, and she would love more company. She's hanging out with Dempsey and Solar Zenith. And we are joined by Mr. Leona himself, who struggled last game, but he's still happy to be here either way with us. Mr. Slut for Turnips himself, Sammy Two Slap. How you doing, Sammy Two Slap? How you feeling after that game?
I'm sad.
You're a little sad? Understandable. You know, everybody's season has to come to an end eventually. I'm sure you'll have better luck next year.
Hey, all I'm going to say is we avoid all three seasons I've been in Titan. I have avoided Gauntlet, and I've always made playoffs.
You Something did not you avoid... See. That's not true, because you played for What Would Joey Do?
I technically switched over to AFG after, so I still made playoffs, so...
Bye-bye. Okay, well, good enough, I guess. Like I said, Corky is in general with Dempsey and Solar Zenith. They would love the company. So if you are not hanging out in general, you are trolling. We are also going to be pausing at 12 seconds. This is game 2 of NFG versus Syndicate. Syndicate is the 6 seed. NFG is the 3 seed. Syndicate did win game 1. The draft is Wukong, Jarvan, Ziggs, Ash, Nautilus on the side of Syndicate Esports. And then it is Darius, Amumu, Talia, Kaiza, and Leona on the side of NFG. We are
paused. They paused for us. All right, perfect. Support screens for everybody here. Alright, there we go. We are paused here.
Yeah, we're going to swap screens over. We are excited to be here. We try to stream all the games we possibly can, so if games go a little, we do try to stream them. You can catch game 1 of this series. It will be on YouTube this week. So it will be on YouTube. I do not know what happened in game 1, short of that.
I don't either.
I know that NFG lost. That's all.
That's all I know, too. So
we should all be paused at 12 seconds, so we should be able to start right when this starts, so we won't have to change anything, which is kind of nice. I am excited to be here. My voice has not given out yet, so that's a plus.
Just wait till next week.
Like I said, Corky... Oh, next week, don't even get me started. Corky is... Like I said, Corky is in general chat. I still don't see anybody hanging out with her. I'm very disappointed in you guys.
She is very tipsy right now, so now's the best time to
Now is the time, guys. Now
you can get the toe picks.
A summoner has disconnected. Devil Souls
did. Baka will have opponents picked by
tonight, probably. Because
Friday, they'll probably pick tonight. I would assume they would have it done tonight.
Because I have some insider info on that.
Yeah, I think Sammy already knows who they're going to pick if this game goes the way Sammy expects it.
Yes.
Soon.
Because I've talked.
I'm not telling you, boss.
It's not your information.
So gotta see if the game ends. Pause swapped at 29:30. Okay. So we are now all under NFG's pause. General chat with Corky, you are trolling. This is your chance to get all the... Huh?
Is he lagging for you, Sammy?
He is lagging, yes.
Okay, I didn't know if it was the stream or it was me. You are lacking a little bit there. I can kind of make out what you're saying. I just want to make sure it wasn't on the stream side of things.
Interesting. My ping seems to be... I do apologize. Isn't uploading anything in the middle of a cast?
Yeah, you're saying you sound a little bit like a robot.
Hold on.
I do not think it's a stream issue. It is on his side. You know, it is... Everyone's home, so internet usage high right now.
And so is Matt. Matt is high.
Happy 420, yes.
But it's a bubble bath, it's not a bong.
It is a vase with flowers. That's what we're going with. We are paused here. I believe Darius DC has DC again, so we are trying to kind of figure that out. Like I said, internet, it's not the greatest right now.
Coronavirus OP.
We are back. We apologize. We were yelling at Corky in her German dungeon. I can't tell you the rest of that. Is why my
German dungeon. Wow.
Can't tell you the rest.
Chat, would you like to fill in the missing words here?
Please.
Either way, we're happy to be here. I think my internet might be evened out a little bit there, hopefully. Comcast likes to throttle me around 11 o'clock for some and we are in the game.
You are lagging a little bit more.
Again. Yeah, you're still lagging. Lag OP.
Lag OP. This just in from Fossler. Guarantees he wins Gold League. FYI.
Guarantees it. Someone
guarantees it.
Okay. If he does, I will eat my own sock.
Okay. Somebody clip that right now. Somebody clip that right now.
Gotta get at least one bite down.
Anyone who clips it will get banned from the TES server, just saying.
We are excited to be here with the three of us. This is a pretty fun group. Yes. Sammy 2 Slap, now that he's eliminated, will be shoutcasting more come playoff time. So we're excited to have Sammy 2 Slap here.
Informed of that.
I did not sign up for that.
It's too bad.
We delegate here.
Well, then put me on Monday nights with Dempsey.
No, Dempsey does Sunday nights. You'll probably be on Monday nights with me.
Ugh.
This is the better crew. What are you talking about?
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Matching starts for the side of both teams, both starting blue buff.
Ooh, it's J4.
Clip by perfect build. Let's go, perfect.
I can't ban
perfect.
Him.
Excited to be here. The Wukong Darius matchup, I do not play personally. I do feel like Darius wins this matchup in lane. Darius is arguably the best lane bully besides probably Renekton, I would think. Yes. But very interesting pick here.
Just real quick, Major. If you ban perfect from the server, I'll provide TES with a $50 prize pool.
Ooh, but Perfect buys a ton of subs, so I think Perfect's already at the $50 prize pool. Kaiza just eating damage, almost gets the proc off. Kind of disappointing there. If you're going to eat that kind of damage, you got to get the proc off to win the trade. Nothing really going on. Pretty boring matchup mid lane.
Oh, look, another Ziggs.
Yeah, another Ziggs.
I saw Ziggs earlier.
We are excited to be here. I like to see the Nautilus pick. My opinion, the strongest sport in the game. Looking for a Nautilus Q. They both good flash.
Yeah, if Nautilus hit that hook there, J4 was there to capitalize on it, so.
Yeah, that was a really good double flash by them because they probably both die. You're going to eat Nautilus Q into J4 knockup, and you're probably dead. You got to imagine the Jarvan will be coming down bot lane again now that their flash is.
He's going mid.
Ooh, flash is a tad bit early there. I think pushes him off. We got a counter gank by the Moo 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 Moo. Hits Q. Flash is to follow the Jarvan. Talia kind of greeting needs to be very careful here. All in all, nobody died. Tons of flashes down. Love the excitement. Major's feeling his play-by-play tonight.
So Jarvan there tried the high IQ EQ, then flash right at the end. I think he barely missed it there. But yeah, on Jarvan you can do that. You can actually EQ and then right as your Q's about to land, you just flash and you actually can extend the range. I think that's what he tried to do there.
Devil Hosting missing a lot of his abilities. Does overall win the trade, though. That's the power of Darius, everyone. Moo Moo making his way down bot lane. They do not have vision here to see him. Would They do back up, though. Interesting place to put the weight.
Yeah, he has no flash.
Okay. Okay. Really confused at what's going on. He does take a tower shot for this. He does not have flash.
Yeah, he's going to...
He lives one by one.
Ash splashes onto him.
The ash splashes on top of him. I believe Aiwei does die for this. Jarvan's here. Kaiza should die also.
Aw, Lucifer.
Really confused at what Epic Fail is doing there.
He doesn't have flash from the mid gank.
Yeah, he eats a whole tower shot during that. Just instantly basically pops. All in all, Syndicate does come out on top. They do take an extra kill on top of that.
I think the Nautilus actually lives there. If he just walks away, he's back in to try and help the team secure the kill. The Jarvan's behind the
AD. I thought he was dead either way.
I think he would live there.
Yeah, I agree. I think he does live if he doesn't do that. Interesting pick here. Lucifer might be in some trouble because of Kai'Sa passive. Does get the EQ out, though.
Yep. Well, no, they get the dragon. They're able to walk it off.
Yep, got the dragon. Good job. It is a slight gold lead in the side of Syndicate, under 1,000 gold. The Ziggs does have a very comfortable CS lead, but the wave is shoving into Talia, so she should be able to even that out pretty effectively.
Wukong is actually, I wanted to give credit to Mons here. He's actually playing this matchup really well. I know that Darius is missing a lot of his abilities, but he's able to keep the CS kind of even right now. He's actually up 6 CS after the Darius back.
Yeah, Mons is playing this very well. This obviously, the wave's going to shove in, so Darius will CS lead. Right. But either way, playing the matchup quite well.
Yeah. Lukong right now should be down at least 10 CS.
A little interesting, the IQ of Coconut's down this far in CS. I do think that this is a Ziggs favored matchup. Personal preference, I don't think Talia's the greatest in lane. I think she's just really strong at like getting out of lane. Would love to see, once she is 6, would love to see her and Epic Fail, once Epic Fail hits 6, trying to double gank bot lane.
Yeah, she does have a role here. She is 6.
Yeah, I feel like if you pick Talia, you have to get out of lane. With
yes, you have to use your ability to roam. What's your advantage over Ziggs right now? Like, you're just going to keep sitting here. If you're in lane, you're going to just get poked down, and you can't use that ability to ult because you're half health. You can't, like, you're just going to go in and die. She has to back. Maybe she walks down lane after she backs you.
Amumu really out farming the Jarvan. The Jarvan does have a kill under his belt, so that's cool. Darius really far up, taking a really... I'm pretty sure Darius just dies. Flash is out. I'm not sure if he gets out here. Probably not, I don't
huge
think.
Heal
holy
off
healing off of Q. What is that?
Ziggs ult missing.
Talia's backing, so she doesn't even help him.
Another heal.
Devil Hosting just taking him on a very merry go-around chase. Once again, so confused at what's going on.
I missed the Q there. He's going to die now.
He's probably dead here, I think, but they are...
Holy
We're
shit.
Having a chase.
What was
yes, Sammy. I don't know what that was either. And this is exactly what 420 means, though. As Talia, if you're just getting poked out in lane, if the Talia's there to roam, our roam there, they win that 2v2, I think.
Yes.
But seeing as Talia's already poked out, has half health, she just backs, kind of leaves her top laner to die, basically. No offense. Little disappointing there. Epic Fail was on the bot side of the map. He tried to look bot side, but bot lane smartly was playing very safe, couldn't get anything off. Downfall does have a slight CS lead bot lane, but I'm pretty sure the Ashe is winning in gold.
Jarvan does not have ult.
Amumu has ultimate here. This is very greedy by Syndicate.
Yeah, they have to back off. They have to just give this.
Verlotax could be in a lot of trouble. Oh no! Worst case scenario there. This is probably going to be Darius R. Instantly kills him. Good turnaround by NFG. Very greedy by Syndicate. They do get the Rift Herald. They lose Talia 2 people for it.
Just have to walk down the river. Epic Fail really wants this.
Yeah, Epic Fail chasing for no absolute reason. He's I think the Wukong wins this. Yeah, I'm very confused at what's going on now. Overall, Syndicate does get Rift Herald, does lose 2 people for that. But you got Rift Herald. So I think if they use the Rift Herald correctly, I think that's...
Yeah. who's down here?
Amumu does get the Leona gets the catch. That is a flash down by Nautilus. That's, you know, you do blow Nautilus flashes there, but you blow Leona R. That's okay. Could be worse. You lived. That's what matters. Amumu is just saving his ult until next game.
Yep.
Well, if they lose this, there is no next game.
Exactly, that's the point. A little interesting that he's saving his ult for so long.
I mean, I get not using it there on the Nautilus. Like, I think they knew he kind of had flash. The ult there, you're probably not going to get that kill anyway. He's just going to flash over the wall.
Maybe
if you could follow it up with a, if you follow it up with a Q over the wall middle after he flashes, then I think it's worth.
Right. Interesting. The Wukong does. Yeah. Hopefully for the dragon fight, it pays off. I do think it was interesting he didn't use it during the Rift Herald fight because it would have been up again. But
I would have used it there for sure. Like, it would already be back up with it almost.
Yeah. It was probably best to save. Syndicate is setting up for the dragon fight. He was six. Yeah, he had a level lead on the Jarvan. Yeah, so that's why I said a little interesting there. The dragon is down to 1300 health, almost dead. We do have a Mumu R still up. Yeah, good ult by the Mumu. Does lose the dragon. Good TP by the Wukong though, and this is going to be a clean for Syndicate, I'm assuming. Still fighting. Ziggs is gonna definitely kill Lumen there. Darius does not have TP. Very good TP usage by the Wukong. Darius does get a plate.
Maybe use Rift bottom here.
Maybe do. They are gonna use Rift. 100% worth for Syndicate at this point, just because of the Rift usage too.
Oh yeah, they're gonna get at least three power plates.
Three.
Do they get first tower?
They get fourth here. They do not get first tower.
Lumen and Kaiza are coming to mech. I think that Darius only got one plate. A little disappointing.
They're gonna get it.
They might get first tower off this.
Oh.
Yeah, they get first tower. Wow.
No rotations at all.
They ended up getting first tower, so I think that's actually quite worth by Syndicate. Like, you get first tower, you get all five plates, expand your gold league to almost 2k. You would really like to see the Taliyah have more impact. You draft Taliyah so she has impact on the map.
Yeah.
And honestly, Taliyah's done.
She had ult there, she has barrier, like she could have roamed down and prevented that turret from going down for sure.
Yeah, you would like to see Taliyah do a little bit more for sure, just because of what you're picking. Like, the Ziggs should not be beating you on pressure, even like map pressure. Okay, it happens, you know what I mean? Maybe you're just not comfortable in the pick. I guess we'll find out. Long game still, so we'll see, you know? Things seem to be semi-stabilizing. I don't think... I'm a little confused at why the Kai'Sa's still bot lane. Mons will straight up 1v1 her at this point, so that's a little on the greedy end. You should probably be lane swapping. A little bit of bad macro.
Yeah, Syndicate's already moved their bot lane to the top. Still 30 seconds here on current place, so maybe it'll get one more.
Yeah.
Darius is up here with Leona.
Yeah, a little late on the shift there for the Kai'Sa.
Getting Kai'Sa back now. Got a wave shoving in here. Apparently Leona's gonna soak it. Alright, she's trying to pull it off the tower, but gonna miss at least half of it. Or all of it. Leona says mine.
Good job by the Taliyah is just basically wave clearing at the point. The problem with that is you're never going to beat the Ziggs in wave clear battle anyways.
No.
Jarvan and Nautilus setting up a bush gank, looking just for somebody to, you know, walk by, I'm assuming. Nautilus has a lot of power at this point. It's a very strong champion.
What is looking for? Are they going to engage here? They do? I have a pinch here.
And if she... Yeah, you don't have your Amumu, though, so I think that's a little on the greedy end.
Yeah, I'll take it.
Things stabilize again. Still a 1.5k gold lead for Syndicate. Most of that is in the mid lane difference. Top side does have a CS lead, but Wukong has two assists.
1,300 gold right now.
Yeah, the most of, yeah, exactly. The gold difference is all mid lane. I don't know what the picks and bans were here, like what the bans were, because I was not here for draft, so I don't know 100% why it's on Talia. I've never really seen him play Talia, so I don't know if that's like a coconut champion. Interesting nonetheless, though.
Well, it definitely is a champion.
Coconut. It's definitely a champion. I'll agree to that. Yeah, game's still early. Ash does get her Bork, her first actual power spike. Bork is extremely strong item. Obviously, Wukong's probably backing for his Bork also right now. The Mumu is farming very well. I'll give him that. Ooh, misses the cannon. Feels bad.
Second rift here.
Second rift. I do not. It does not look like NFG is going to contest second rift. They are on the opposite side of the map.
Yeah, looks like we're just gonna set up a dry. We're gonna have a classic dragon for rift trade.
Classic dragon for rift. Probably the trade NFG has to make here because they've already given up two dragons. You can't really afford to give up three dragons at 16 minutes. Hopefully NFG actually makes the play for the dragon here, because if they don't, I'm very confused at why they gave up a second rift for no reason. They are gonna blow a rift mid lane. Makes a ton of sense.
I don't know if they can get there in time.
They have Talia R.
Close.
Okay, they do get the dragon. Gets interrupted off Nautilus R. Downfall is probably dead. Nope, flash is over. But can they hit the blast cone? Hits the blast. Nope, too late.
Oh, guys,
a little confused at what's going on here with the what they're doing. A little very disjointed.
He's also gonna die.
NFG just super disjointed there at what they're trying to do. They do get the dragon, which is good. Amumu has flash. Just flash over the back of the pit if you're gonna do that.
I think he was looking to re-engage because he had ult.
He got Nautilus ulted out of his Q.
Bandage shots.
Yeah, out of his banish shot, so that's problematic for them, obviously. But the Darius just watching a looming die there, a little questionable. Maybe the call was to get out, but if the call was to get out, I'm a little confused why the Moomin didn't just flash over the back of the pit. Either way, very disjointed, but overall, win for Syndicate. They do lose the dragon, they get three kills, which is pretty worth, and it balloons the gold lead to 3k.
And they also get the mid turret off of the rift. Fail his DC, we're not getting a pause.
Nope. He's like, go on without me.
We don't need to
do it. This seems like a ton of tilt on NFG's side. I do not understand what happened game one. I'm assuming tilt is really big on this right now. I'm assuming it looks like Epic's just having internet problems. I understand not having to pause there because everything and where it is.
Yeah, maybe he said he was reconnecting. All right, there's someone to use one of their pauses there.
Right, you're
going to use one of the pauses.
Yep, that makes sense. It just looks like tilt on the side of their jungler. They look very disjointed at what they want to do. Whereas NFG is usually really good macro. They make up for their they lack individual. Like, I wouldn't say like their individual players are best in their roles. I wouldn't say that, but they make up for it by being good. But it just looks very not. Does not look like it. Game's far from over. No, maybe we'll see a little something. Kai'Sa does scale really well. I am not 100% sure who scales the best out of this team, because I think Kai'Sa and Mumu scales really well. Wukong also scales well, and I think Ashe Zig scales well, so I think Syndicate scales better.
I think so far we're seeing a big difference in the mid lane. Like, at almost 20 minutes, Leah still hasn't been able to finish her Luden's Echo. I think it's, what is that, 800 gold to complete, so she's almost there.
I haven't seen one hit to Liar.
Yeah, he hasn't had any map presence.
That's literally why you can...
Yes. Unfortunate.
I don't know what bans were, so I don't know if maybe they threw, you know, five bans at Coconut for all I know. But interesting nonetheless. Kaiza just greeting really hard here. You can't be that far out without vision in any way, shape, or form. Like, all your vision's on top side, but yet your Kaiza's the one on bot side. Like, if you're going to do that, your Darius should be the one on bot side, and your Kaiza should be top. Doesn't make a ton of sense. Like I said, I don't know if this is tilt from game one or what. Good flash by the Darius. Good for them to try to make a play here. Does kill Mr. Tuggles. Poor Mr. Tuggles. I love your name, though. Kills the Nautilus here. Very good play by Devil Hosting and Illumin trying to make a play. When you're down this much gold, obviously making a play. Yep. That does turn the gold leads roughly 3K, which is not impossible to come back. A lot of the gold's in the Jarvan. I'm assuming Jarvan's gonna build tank. Yeah. No. We'll see.
Yeah, he has a little MR with the...
MR makes sense. Yeah, yeah. Because of the comps. Makes sense.
Yeah, maybe we're going straight tank as well, so...
Yeah. Interesting enough game, though. Illumin having a quietly good game. Downfall, being kind of behind. Kaiza does have the potential to 1v9. Late game, I think we all know how strong Kaiza is late game. The problem is it's going to be a long time till. I'm assuming he's building Rageblade right now.
Atalia has Luden's finish now, so her wave there gets a little bit better. Ooh, damage
at 21 minutes.
It was definitely significantly delayed. We'll put it that way.
Yep. They are setting up for the Baron. Mons does have TP, so you gotta expect this is gonna be a 5v5.
Yep.
NFG backing off the dragon to reset the dragon. Okay, they did blow Mons' TP, so I guess that's good. That is the clone. Please do not jump on that. I will flame you. They do not have wave control.
No
Jarvan hit. Kaiza doesn't have flash. Talia's trapped, baby. Does kill the Jarvan. Talia probably dies from this. The Darius is just all over the backline, though. Does go down. A Mubuar hits four people. Kaiza gets in for some reason melee ranges and just walks right into the Nautilus queue. Really confused. Really bad positioning by Downfall there, to be honest. Downfall had ultimate too. Like, you have to position that better. Dragon goes over to Syndicate Esports. It was a really good try by Epic Fail. He did hit a 4-man ult.
He's not building the AP Amumu, so it doesn't quite have like the oomph behind it. And unfortunately, it's a little too late when he ults. Like, unless his team's already dead. And like,
yeah, Kaiza just needs ult on the backside of that. Yep.
No reason
preference.
To rock right into it. Just ult right behind them. Get the shield.
Yeah, a little interesting on a communication thing. I think Lucifer did die there, but I understand Lucifer's concept. He did hit a pretty good ultimate. It did not hit the Talia, but it locked the Talia between the ultimate and the wall. So, like, that's the biggest thing I would say. Talia was able to do basically nothing that fight. Darius did have to 1v4 the backline, and he lived long enough. Well, I guess Darius and Lumi, so 2v4 the backline. He did live long enough to get it so that their carries weren't able to fight, which is why Lucifer died. So short of that, I would say a complete and utter win for a Syndicate there. They're on Dragon Soul. NFG is our third place team, but NFG has fallen off. NFG has fallen off the last couple of weeks. They did have a chance to get first place seed, and then they kind of just got. So I wouldn't say, like, I picked Syndicate to win this matchup because I do think that NFG beat a lot of teams off pure just macro and team play.
Syndicate team that we saw. There's a lot of roster changes there at the end of the season, and they are
and Syndicate's been winning. Syndicate's on like a 3-game winning streak. 4-game winning streak, whereas NFG's on like a 3-game losing streak.
Yeah, they're just kind of at opposite spectrums, like of season-wise. Like, NFG started out really well, kind of tapered off. Syndicate started out very poorly, and then now they've found their groove here with the right roster makeup. They're bush camping here, kind of sample check. They already know they're not on Baron, so.
Yeah, they already have the ward there. The Ziggs is not there. Ziggs does have TP to join the fight. Ziggs isn't really the person I want to TP at the backside of the fight, personally. But I do understand the logic here. Ziggs will burn towers.
See Darius top.
He is Ziggs. Yeah, Darius trying to gank the Darius here. NFG is going mid lane to try to get the tower. Darius probably should back off here, but Darius does not back off. Walks into the bush check. Messes up his flash. I apologize for my language. And dies.
Ziggs does get bottom tower as well. NFG is just kind of hovering around mid.
If Devil Hosting gets the flash over the wall, it's a very good flash. He just flashed a little early. Syndicate is this. Baron's probably. NFG's just backing.
I don't know what NFG's doing.
Yeah, you have to assume they're on Baron. They just cleared
division,
and they just killed Darius top lane. You have to assume they're on Baron right now. Epic fails bot lane, so they're just giving it up. I'm very confused.
Ziggs. Get the pick on Ziggs. I don't even know if they get that. I don't think they do.
Yeah, and then Epic fail one dies to the 1v1 Ziggs. Literally so confused at what NFG's doing. I don't know if this is tilt or they're just giving. Very confused.
Say it was 25-6 in game one. That's what I saw in Twitch chat. Black Swan.
The last time I casted NFG, they did the same thing where Bakaprisco was taking Baron, and you know Bakaprisco was taking Baron, and Epic fails bot lane for absolutely no reason. Gotta really wonder the man's macro and what he's doing. I love Epic Fail. He's one of my, I consider him my a friend, but I don't know if this is tilt or just really.
Yeah, who's doing the macro? We're all kind of hovering mid while Ziggs was taking bottom. Darius is getting picked off. Like there's those like no real.
And then you know they're on Baron and you don't. Like very confused. Like I don't know if it feels like NFG's just kind of giving up.
Yeah, the call I guess was to pick Ziggs. They don't even get that. Like Ziggs is so strong right now. He's got a 4K gold lead over Taliyah. Like.
And the Taliyah doesn't even help, like, but Taliyah just tries, but it's like, what are you going to do?
Playing a mid champion that can literally...
This is an instant engage. The Moomoo instantly pops, barely gets ultimate off. The Jarvan is 1v1ing the Taliyah, that's not a good sign.
Leona is also going to be caught out and killed here.
I gotta assume this is really bad. They do kill the Kai'Sa. Devil's Hosting doing all he can, legitimately trying to 1v9. Instantly die, as this will be Ocean Soul for Syndicate. No offense, I don't like to call games over before they're over, but unless if Syndicate gets a throw, DCs two of their players, and decides to play 3v5, this game is absolutely. Ocean Soul, 10k gold lead. It would take a momental throw. By Syndicate for this game, not to lose, not to win this game.
Yeah. I mean, I looking at where this went wrong, I think mid game Taliyah just never got out of lane. She just literally stayed in lane the entire game.
Taliyah has a kill participation of 2.
Yep.
Is down 60 CS.
Ziggs is just doing so much damage.
Like obviously, there's more problems than just that, but the screaming one. The micro mistake by Downfall, just straight melee rage eating the Nautilus hook, and in a team fight that they really could is also very questionable. They are gonna back out and reset, and then you got to assume that they're just gonna go bot lane and just down their throat. I do appreciate NFG is trying still. They did not forfeit, which I appreciate. You know, I have seen teams forfeit during actual tournament games, and I think that's very BM.
So here's the 12k gold question. How do they get back into this game? Is there a way?
If verbal toxicity and Lucifer that's how they win the game. No, all seriousness, it would take a class macro mistake by Syndicate. Like, you would have to get caught out multiple times. I don't know. I honestly don't know how they win this game. If you're Syndicate here, you just send five pot lane. You have Ziggs. You win the push battle. You win the poke battle. Amumu has to hit a five-man ultimate on top of a Lumen's five-man ultimate. And Kai'Sa has to do something. That's a lot of question marks.
Yeah. It's like right here. You got to find these picks.
You got to get
low probability and just hope that it does.
Yeah, you got to do something. Game's over. So, like, do something here. Like, the Ziggs isn't there.
Darius there, yep. You literally 3v5 mid right now. You got to take it. Go.
I feel like you have to take a fight here. Like, I'm a big prevailer.
Go on Jarvan?
Go on Jarvan? Okay, they're all take. Are they taking it? They blow him. Okay, they don't. They kind of have to take the fight, but then don't take the fight. Super confused. This is going to be GG here. Yeah. Jarvan ults on top of the on Coconut. Coconut's dead. They take inhib, and that is going to be good game, short of Syndicate straight up trolling.
We still have a move to ult. Wave is gonna eventually.
Yeah, very confused on that fight. Very disjointed again. Like, yeah. You have a move R, you don't even use it. So confused. Does blow ult, but have no follow up now because all your follow up's dead. Downfall's gonna die here, most likely. Yep, and that's GG. Syndicate moves on. I'm assuming it will be Syndicate. I'm assuming it'll be Syndicate versus InnerLogic and Baka versus NGC. I'm assuming.
I'm gonna use my big brain and say that Baka is going to pick.
NGC. That's what I personally would do if I was Baka, because Syndicate's on such a winning streak. That's my personal preference. But maybe they don't. We'll see. Either way, Syndicate moves on. NFG is eliminated. Our 6 seed did beat our 3 seed. I want to say congratulations to Syndicate. NFG, better luck next year. For those of you here, we will look at the damage screens. As you can imagine, the Ziggs has 28k damage. What really bugs me a tad bit is the Taliyah has 6k damage.
Yes.
There's an outlier here.
I also was a little hard on Coconut last time I casted his game, because he played Azir and he did like the least damage on the team. Obviously, he did beat Leona. But yeah. Downfall tried his hardest. What are you going to do? A couple micro mistakes. The Nautilus did more damage than the Taliyah. That's problematic. You will find out this week who they play. It will be announced. I'm assuming Baka Preschool would pick, if Baka Preschool's smart, they probably pick NGC just because of the fact Syndicate has so much momentum right now. We are excited. Next weekend will be best of fives. You can catch myself Sunday for Olympian League semifinals, where we have Syndicate Esports versus, I believe, Duke Diddly Dongers, and we have Leaf Elites versus Baka Onitan. I will be here for those best of fives. From those of us at Titan Esports, we want to say thank you for joining us. From myself, 420, and Mr. Two Slap here, I hope everybody has a wonderful night.
Good night.